Again, I apologize for the delay as I was having technical difficulties joining this guru meeting. So we're all set now. So before we start the actual topic, let's discuss about Vinwire, who we are and what we do. So we are an IT services company. We mostly work on Microsoft technologies and specialize in them, such as SharePoint, Microsoft .NET, ASP.NET, reporting services. We work on SQL Server, and then we do SSRS and using ClickView, Tableau. We have recently also started developing mobile applications, native applications in iOS and Android. And we do hybrid applications as well using HTML5. And we have partnered with Appsulator to create hybrid applications using Titanium Studio that will have a single code base for multiple platforms. So that's, in short, an introduction about Vinwire. All right. Coming to today's topic, SkyDrive Pro beyond cloud storage. What we're going to discuss today is first we'll go through SkyDrive, what is SkyDrive, and then I'll be giving you an introduction about SkyDrive Pro. What are the features, what are the benefits of using SkyDrive Pro, and then we are going to look at what are the different apps that SkyDrive Pro provides you. Then we are going to see the sync architecture of SkyDrive Pro, like how you can do offline storage and stuff like that using synchronization. Lastly, we are going to see integration of SkyDrive Pro and Office 2013, so where you can see features that Office 2013 provides you to use SkyDrive Pro. And then we are going to see some of the mobile apps that are available today to work with SkyDrive Pro. So that's in brief like what we are going to talk about. All right. Moving on, let's see first what is SkyDrive before going to SkyDrive Pro. So SkyDrive, officially known as Microsoft SkyDrive, previously called Windows Live SkyDrive and Windows Live Folders, is a file hosting service that allows the users to upload and sync files to a cloud storage and then access them from a web browser or a local device such as a mobile device. So it is a part of Windows Live range of online services that allows users to keep their files private or share them with contracts or make the files public to the entire world. Now, when you share a file from SkyDrive, the person with whom you are sharing it to doesn't need to have a Microsoft account. So that's an important thing. You can just provide a link and then they can use that link to view your file. And then you can give permissions to Microsoft users such as whether they can just view it or even edit it for that matter. So that's in short about SkyDrive. Like it's a cloud storage where you can put some files, share it with the users. All right. Coming to SkyDrive Pro, okay. Now SkyDrive Pro is your professional library. Like SkyDrive is more personal, it's more professional, and by default it's private. It's one place to keep your work documents and other files. So you can think of SkyDrive Pro as your SkyDrive for business. So when you store your files on SkyDrive Pro, so only you can see them. But you can easily share it with co-workers and other people within the organization, using which they can either see it using a browser or using a mobile device. So your files are safely kept in the cloud now with SharePoint Online or on your company's SharePoint 2013 server. So depending on what your company has to set up. So if you see here, it is a cloud storage, but you can also have an on-premise storage. So if you're using Office 365 with SharePoint Online, then you can use SkyDrive Pro as a cloud service, or you can use SharePoint 2013 that provides you SkyDrive Pro, and then the files and everything will be stored on-premise for that. So it's cloud storage and on-premise, which you can control depending on your company setup. And there are two kinds of storage. Again, one is online, that is when you're connected to the internet, and then you can access it online, access the documents online. And then you can also work in the offline mode when you do not have connectivity. You can work on the offline version and then later point of time you can sync your documents when you have the connection back. So again, you have SharePoint 2013 integration, Office 2013 integration, and then you have mobile apps for Windows, iOS, and Android. So what are the key things, key features of SkyDrive Pro? There are three features I would say. One is like you can store and organize your private documents and other files in a secure location on the cloud or on your company SharePoint servers, as we discussed. That is one of the things. And the second thing is you can share files and folders with other people in your organization and give them the permission to review or edit the document, so you have control, like whether you just want to give read-only access or write access to the file. And then thirdly, you can synchronize files and folders in your SkyDrive Pro and other SharePoint libraries with your computer or mobile devices, so you can easily access your content offline. So again, you have two modes, online and offline. So those are the key features of SkyDrive Pro. Moving on. So when do you choose SkyDrive and when do you choose SkyDrive Pro? So as I said, SkyDrive is more of a personal library. It's a free online storage that provides you with storage space that you can use to upload your files and then access it using your browser or mobile devices. And then you can share it with your friends and even collaborate on the content. So you are free to decide like how you want to use it. You can either share it with one person or share it with everyone. And then you have again different access. Basically personal things such as your vacation pictures, recipes, baseball schedule, or anything like that, you can put it on SkyDrive. But when you come to SkyDrive Pro, it provides you with a personal library, again, but for business. So there you can upload and access business-related documents and other files from your computer. So SkyDrive Pro library is managed by your organization. So here, this thing is different. It's not managed by you, but it's managed by your organization and allows you to share and collaborate on content with your coworkers. So your site collection administrator controls how you use the library. So in addition, with the SkyDrive Pro Sync client, you can synchronize library files and folders with your local computer. So we're going to see about sync as we move on. So the main point to note is that your company administrator actually controls the SkyDrive Pro usage rather than like your SkyDrive. So in SkyDrive Pro, you can have any event pictures, specification documents, presentations of your corporate work. All that goes into SkyDrive Pro. Again, two options of storing it, either on the cloud or on-premise using SharePoint 2013. Right. So let's see what are the benefits of using SkyDrive Pro. So one of the things is users can share the documents offline. Store the documents offline and then synchronize when they are online again. That's one benefit. And users can synchronize across all client devices and servers where the files are stored and synchronized. So you can synchronize them across multiple devices. So multiple users can work on documents at the same time. So that's one of the advantages. And the SkyDrive Pro's Windows Sync client will synchronize the changes between the users. And if there are conflicts, users are prompted to resolve those conflicts. So you can have multiple users work on the same file at the same time. And then when you try to actually upload it back to SkyDrive Pro, then you are prompted for resolving any of the conflicts that occur. And then users can work from many locations, either online or offline, and also work from many devices. So that means that you can have the same set of folders or files on different devices. Like you can have it on your laptop, you can have it on your desktop or a mobile device, and then you can work across across devices on the same files. So those are some of the benefits of using SkyDrive Pro. So let's see what is a SkyDrive Pro library. A SkyDrive Pro library is made available to you as a service through your organization's Office 365 and SharePoint Online account, or through its installation of the SharePoint 2013. So you can organize and store Word documents or other files in your personal SkyDrive Pro library, and from there you can easily share files and collaborate on documents with coworkers in your company. So if you're signed into Office 365, you may be also able to share documents with partners which are outside of the organization. So if you see, I'm having a screenshot here. Where you have Office 365 options, where you can see SkyDrive. So in the header, when you see SkyDrive, it's basically SkyDrive Pro, which appears without the Pro abbreviation. So that's using Office 365, you can share it outside your organization as well. All right, now let's talk about SkyDrive Pro apps. So basically, what are the apps that work with SkyDrive Pro? One is you have an Office Sync, right? We're going to talk about that, how it does synchronization and stuff like that. Then you have the backstage view, and then the most recently used in Office apps. So when you're using MS Office, how backstage view works and how most recently used files work, that we're going to see. The third thing is the Windows Phone Office Hub. As I said, there are multiple mobile devices, I mean mobile applications available for SkyDrive Pro. One is the Windows, and then you also have versions for iOS and Android available as well, using which you can access the content on your SkyDrive Pro using your mobile devices. All right. Let's talk about sync. Sync, which is also called as synchronization, this is a process that involves copying, updating, and moving files between a client workstation and the server, or vice versa. That is, from the server to the client workstation. So in SkyDrive Pro, synchronization is performed by the SkyDrive Pro Windows Sync client. So you get a client which is either installed with Office 2013. So if you install Office 2013, you get that installed by default. Or it is available as a standalone version also. You can download your Windows Sync client from the Microsoft website. So, and this can be used with the previous versions of Office as well. Not only Office 2013, it will work with Office 2010 and Office 2007 as well. So that is your Windows Sync client. SkyDrive Pro or Windows Sync client enables users to take documents offline from document libraries in SharePoint 2013, and then use them when they are disconnected from the SharePoint server. So later, when the client workstation reconnects to SharePoint server, the files are synchronized back. So the SkyDrive Pro Windows Sync client synchronizes files with any document library in SharePoint server, including the SkyDrive Pro document library. So that is sync client that is available to you, that you can work to store your content offline and then synchronize it. So it synchronizes all other folders in SharePoint as well as the SkyDrive Pro folder. So when you synchronize it, basically like it creates a desktop icon in the favorites section, where you can see your SkyDrive Pro library, and then you can access all your files from that location. So here is an architecture of your Windows Sync client that accesses all the sites from SharePoint 2013 server, or from the team site, or from the cloud, which is not there. So how does synchronization work? So let's see, there are multiple ways how it works. One is automatic sync. So the SkyDrive Pro Windows Sync client automatically synchronizes with SharePoint 2013 every 10 minutes. So when the SkyDrive Pro Windows Sync client makes the request to synchronizing with SharePoint server, the SharePoint server might respond by indicating that it is experiencing high resource utilization and cannot synchronize now. So whenever that kind of thing happens, the SkyDrive Pro Windows Sync client cancels the current synchronization request and then resends a new synchronization request after some time. So it keeps on checking that, so for every 10 minutes. So that is automatic syncing. But then you have adaptive syncing. So a user where a user can access the SkyDrive Pro Windows Sync client from the notification area in the Windows. So where you see your clock and everything, you have the sync client available from where you can access it. So using that client, a user can select sync now, pause syncing, open your SkyDrive Pro folder, and so on. So you can do all those tasks using that. The Windows Sync client establishes a synchronization relationship with the document library when the user clicks the sync button in the SharePoint server. So when a synchronization relationship is set up, files and folders can be synchronized between the client workstation and the SharePoint server. So the SkyDrive Pro Windows Sync client creates shortcuts displayed in, as I was telling you, it creates shortcuts in the Windows Explorer to Windows folders. And then let's see the third part, which is your Word, Excel, and PowerPoint, how it is different from automatic syncing. So how the syncing is different in those files. So if the file type is a Word, Excel, or PowerPoint file, the SkyDrive Pro Windows Sync client performs a differential synchronization. So which is a synchronization of only the changes that were made to the document between the last synchronization and the current synchronization. So it does a compare between the existing file on this online on the SkyDrive Pro and your local version, and then only synchronizes the changes that have been made. So that is called as differential synchronization. For any other type of files, the Windows Sync client synchronizes the whole file, so not just the changes. So that's the difference when you when you're syncing files of Word, Excel, PowerPoint, or any other file. So you do a differential sync on Office files. Let's see the architecture of Sync client. So basically, you have your SkyDrive Pro UI as a top layer, which is your presentation layer. And that UI can be your Sync client or your apps, your Windows apps or an iOS app. And then you have the client storage, which is your SharePoint server or your cloud server with Office 365. And then at the bottom, you have the services, the SkyDrive Pro services and SharePoint 2013 services. So that's on a very high level the architecture of synchronization on SkyDrive Pro. As I talked about, Microsoft Office is Office 2013 is tightly integrated with SkyDrive Pro. So you can see what you can do using Office 2013 with SkyDrive Pro. So let's talk about the backstage view first. In Office 2013, the backstage view provides the file level functionality in the Office applications. So in Office 2013, a user can access the backstage view by clicking the file in the ribbon. In Office 2013, each client application can share information and actions via the backstage view. So Office applications such as Word, Excel, PowerPoint, OneNote use the backstage view to access the shared documents. The Office 2013 client applications use the backstage view with SharePoint Server 2013 to open and save files to the document libraries on SharePoint. So once the SkyDrive Pro Windows Sync client synchronizes with the document library, and the user opens or saves the file in the synchronized Windows folder, the document library puts it into the backstage view as an open and save location. So alternatively, if an administrator configures the SharePoint 2013 to exchange auto discovery, the user's SkyDrive Pro document library will be listed as an open or save location. So on the backstage, whenever you open a file and when the Windows Sync client synchronizes it, so you have a open and save file in the backstage view. So that's about the backstage. And then we'll see how you can save a file using Office 2013 directly onto SkyDrive Pro, and then we can see how you're going to share the files using Office 2013, and then we are going to see like what is roaming, basically most recently used files displayed on different clients with this. So when you use Office 2013, if you see the Save As dialog, and if you click on Microsoft there it will show you the SkyDrive Pro folder as well. So when you're signed in into my Office 2013, because you have the ability to sign in using your credentials. So if you're using your Microsoft credentials, Microsoft Live credentials, then what it does is it automatically connects you to your SkyDrive Pro library. And then you can see that library over here. So from directly from Office 2013, you are allowed to save your files onto SkyDrive Pro. So that's one of the features of Office 2013 integration with SkyDrive Pro. Okay. Now, sharing of files is again very simple using Office itself. You select a file and then you select share. Then you have option to invite people where you can enter the email addresses of your coworkers and then just send it, and then they can use that link to view your files. And then you can even control the access, like whether you want to give a view access or a write access. And then it also shows you whom you have shared this file with, along with adding more people to share. Recent list. This is a very interesting feature in Office 2013. So when you log on to your computer with your domain credentials and then open an Office application, so Office automatically recognizes you, like who you are. Your picture and name are displayed on the upper right corner of the screen to show you that you're signed in. So if you see the Office 2013 screen, like any of the applications such as Word or Excel, you can see that your name and your picture is displayed on the top right hand corner, which indicates that you have already signed in. So because Office is associated with your credentials, so your Office documents roam with you even when you are moving to a different computer or a device. So as long as you have signed it with your same credentials. So for example, let's say you're working on an Excel spreadsheet at work. So you save the document to SkyDrive Pro, close the document, and then use a different computer or other device when you're on the road. So if you're signed into Office, when you open the Excel on the new device, your recent documents are displayed on the left side of the start screen. So you can see that you get right back to the work on your document. So once you close the document on one device, say for example, if I'm working on my laptop, and then I go to another location, say my home, so if I open it on my desktop, so if I'm using the same credentials, so the recent list that you see when you click on file, it's the same list that was there at your Office laptop. So that's how it works. So it uses your credentials, it knows who you are, and then it provides you options. So basically, it's like you're working on the same computer. You don't feel any different. So you're right on your work. Moving on, here I have some of the screenshots of Windows mobile application. So you see, you have the Microsoft Office Office app. If you tap on that, you see a SkyDrive account, and then you can open your SkyDrive Pro folder, and then you can see all the documents and folders available here. So from here as well, you can access the document as you can access using your web browser or a desktop client. Apart from that, you also have iOS apps available for SkyDrive Pro. Here is an example of your iPad app where I'm showing you how you can share your file with someone. You can just use the share feature and then type the email address and then send a link to them, using which they can access the file. And then you have the offline storage that we talked about a number of times, where you can have your storage, have your SkyDrive Pro files stored offline, then you can work on them when you are not connected, and then later sync them with your SharePoint or cloud service. So that's your SkyDrive Pro iOS app sample. So with this, we come to an end of today's session. So if you have any question and answers, feel free to type them in, and then we'll definitely get back with the answers to you.
Sure. Hey, thanks, Amit. It was very informative. Some of you have asked like whether we'll be sharing the slides of this session. Definitely, yes. We'll be sending out the slide decks for you to view post this session, maybe in next 24 hours of time. And we'll wait for a few seconds to check in case if any attendees have any questions. Okay, I think none of you have questions, and in case if you have any questions, please feel free to write at marketing@winwire.com, and we'll get back to you. And have a good day, and thank you for attending this webinar session. Thank you, Amit. Thank you, everyone. Bye.
Thank you.
Yeah.